Well, hey everybody, it's John Redman. I'm back here in the shop, and today we're going to walk you through installing electric retracts in your Habu 2. Pretty simple and easy process, but for those out there that have never done it before, we're going to walk you through step by step, show you exactly what it takes, and in about 30 minutes you're going to be in the air flipping that switch, pulling the gear into the retracted position for a little bit of extra added performance on your Habu at the park, having a great time. So basically what you're going to need is you're going to need your Habu 2 airframe, and I have mine sitting here on the table in front of us, and as you can see, I have the wing not installed on the fuselage, and that'll enable us to put everything in a much easier format in the video. Along with that, we have our electric retracts, and this is the 10 to 15 size from E-flite tricycle landing gear set. EFLG110 is the part number, and these give you just about everything you need to bring everything to life. Instructions are included, and of course we're going to follow the instructions in the Habu 2 manual on how to install the retracts. So we have a nose gear and a couple of main gear. You have the triple wire harness, as it's called. Now this is included with the retracts, but also in the Habu, the Y harness is already included for the main landing gear, and we'll need this later on in the end to hook everything up. And then we have our separate axles that are adjustable to set our size. And we're going to go ahead and get set, bring stuff to life. The Habu 2 instruction manual, pretty straightforward, and in there it shows you exactly what you need to do to install the landing gear. So we're going to do the nose gear first. So the first step in this is, according to the instructions, is we need to make two marks on our wire from the base of the coil, which is the bottom, and I'm using my E-flite ruler, and I'm going to make two marks. I can get my ruler here. One is at 1 inch, and one is at 2 1/4 inches. Now, what that is for, the 2 1/4 inch mark is where we are going to cut off and remove the lower part of the strut. The first mark, we are going to bend the wire at about a shallow 15 degree angle so that the wheel goes into the airplane in the retracted position. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cut off, and I'll be right back. Okay, so here you can see I have made my cut, and this was done with a Dremel and a 409 cutoff wheel to remove the lower half of that strut. We're not going to need that anymore. Next, we're going to go ahead and do a bend, and the bend is going to want to be straight back and angled into, I guess you would say, kind of the retract unit. So I'm going to hold and very carefully make a nice little about a 10 degree bend, and we may finalize that bend a little bit more once we're installed and see where everything fits inside the airplane. These dimensions are all per the manual that's included with the Habu 2. And the next thing we want to do is we want to take one of our axles, and we are going to install it and I'm just kind of snugging up slightly to where I can still turn it. Remove the wheel collar that's on here. And I'm going to hunt through my landing gear included with the airplane. We install the wheel collar so the tire spins nice and free. And this is done, I'm using a 1.5 millimeter Thorpe driver. And so here we have our nose gear pretty much set up. Now what we're going to do is we're going to remove one of the set screws, and using some pacer zap Z42 Loctite, Snug that up nice and tight. And come and do the other side. Now, as a tip, if you'd like, if you fly from really rough fields or tend to have that not so perfect landing, you can come in with your 409 Dremel wheel and put a flat spot, and you're putting the flat spot on the wire itself, right where that set screw, the set screw goes, and do it on each side. And what that'll do is that'll better lock that axle in place and such. If you fly from very nice asphalt runways, and let's just say that your landings are pretty stellar, you land on the mains on a regular basis, you may be able to get away without having to do that. So your choice, whatever your preference is. Okay, we have just finished installing the wheel, the axle, and the bending the strut on the nose retract unit, so that's done. Now we have our nose wheel steering push rod, and this is included with the Habu 2. It's a very beefy unit designed for any rough field operation, whatever you may have, and you'll notice there's also a steering arm included. So the steering arm slips on, the keeper goes on over that, as you can see that there, and then it snaps in place. It's just a very audible click, which secures the entire system. Okay, now we need to install this clevis onto the nose wheel steering arm of the retract before we install it. So you're going to see one side of the arm is straight and the other side is angled out and gives you a much thicker area for the threads to capture. Also, the screw hole is off center. We're going to position this so that the flat part is towards the inside of the steering arm, or the inside of the retract frame. And if you read inside the instructions in the Habu 2, you will find that it tells you to put the thicker side towards a retract frame. If you do that, it will cause a binding. It's a misprint in the manual. It will cause a binding on the screw in the slot. So we want to make sure we're a flat part towards a frame. That's a 1.5 millimeter ball driver, not a Phillips screwdriver. Now, as you can see, I have tightened the screw so tight that the part is very difficult to move. Let's loosen it up a little bit. It needs to be very free moving and simple and easy to where it doesn't catch on anything and it moves very free and easy, as you can see. Once that's done, we're ready to install the nose wheel steering system and the nose wheel steering unit into the airplane. We plug our retract into our extension harness, coordinating the colors, of course. Now with our 3x10 millimeter screws, we will secure the nose unit in place. And to install that last screw, we're going to need to extend the landing gear. I have my DX18 here. And what you need to do is you install the three-way Y harness that comes with the retracts. I've plugged into the extension harness for the nose gear. I'm plugged into the retract port of the receiver. Get the battery secured so it doesn't flop around while we're moving around here. Transmitter on. Nose gear's down. Now I can install that force screw. Here you can see the four screws installed in each one in each corner. Now we're going to install the servo arm on the servo. Okay, so I've removed the servo arm, and now I'm going to come in and I'm going to need to adjust my linkage a bit. So in the stock configuration, the push rod for the nozzle steering as it comes out is too long. So what I have done is I have trimmed some of the threads off with my cutoff wheel, and now I am reinstalling the push rod into the quick link. And you're going to want to go to the point to where the quick link and the snap link keeper are almost bottomed out against each other for the correct dimension. The easy link or the quick link and the easy link together, these two are almost bottomed out against each other for it to be the correct length. And that's about what your push rod's going to want to be. Out of the box, in the bag, it's way too long. You need to trim off some of those threads and then reinstall it. I've got it hooked on here. I'm going to go ahead and install my little screw. And next is the cover cap to give that finished look. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to install the retracts in the main wing. And these are very, very simple. Putting a main unit in on each side, they bolt in place. The big key is looking at the coil. You want the coil, I'm going to call this side back here the back side of the coil. It needs to go towards the trailing edge of the wing so that as when you land, the wire continue, the bend of the wire would continue to coil the coil and not unwind the coil. So very, very simple. We just undo a few bolts here and remove the cover plate. We're going to set the landing gear in place here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Sharpie and I am going to kind of find a place beyond the center of the wheel well, as you can see. And I'm making a mark and I'm going to cut that wire off. As both of these are cut exactly the same, I'm going to measure them and cut them both at the same time. And we'll final trim those in just a minute. So, to install those, we plug our little connector in. As we're going to install the retract into the wing. And that's done with the same four screws that were holding in the original cover and mount. Make sure you get these nice and snug. And now, as you can see, we've got the wire connected, but the connector is just kind of out here in the open. What we're going to do is we're going to bring it down against the side, and I am going to tack it in place with a very small drop of medium CA so that it's out of the way, yet easily removable if we need to remove it at a later date. A light Mista kicker. As this is Z foam, and actually we're gluing this to the plastic, regular CA can be used. It does not need to be foam safe CA. One of the nice things about Z foam. So we're going to go ahead and install the other side, and our retracts are installed. Next, we need to get our axles. 1.5 millimeter driver pulls the wheel collar off. And we're going to install our tire. And if you look at the tire, one side, as you can see, the hub is inset. The other side actually has kind of a little nub or something to offset it outwards more. And that's a size that I put towards the inner portion of the axle. By doing that, it keeps the wheel from hitting the wire as it spins. So we have our wheels installed on our axle, and we're ready to basically, what we're going to do is we are going to extend our retracts, slide our axles in place, set them to where the wheels are centered in the wheel well, And then we're going to snug those down, and then we're going to come back and we're going to trim them and pretty much be done. As we flip this over, the question of the day is, which ones are the retracts? Well, let's just take a guess. Hot dog got lucky. As you can see, I've got the landing gear extended. I have the axle slipped in place. I'm going to retract the gear and hopefully slide this correctly to where it centers in the wheel well. There we go. And once I'm there, I'm going to snug that up a bit. And do the same thing on this side. And the key here is to try and get the wheels in the exact same location in the wheel well. That way the plane will sit level on the ground. Remove the fuselage for a second. Looking down at the airplane, I want to ensure that my wheels are straight and not angled one way or the other. A slight bit of toe in is not a bad thing. That one looks pretty good. So I'm going to snug up one side, remove the other side, and use some Loctite. Okay, so as we finish putting the wing on, you can see the retracts. We got our little wires, our strut wires trimmed. Our toe in set, the airplane rolls nice and straight. At the flip of a switch, gears up. Flip of a switch, the gears down. Nice cool look when you're out there flying. Definitely brings an entire new look to the Habu. Really, really cool flying airplane, and the addition of the retracts helps boost a little performance and, of course, increase the great looks and lines of the airplane in flight. Hope you've enjoyed this little how-to of how to get the retracts inside your Habu and get you headed out to the flying field. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Remember, you can always find me at editors@horizonrc.com. We'll see you at the flying field.